Yeah. So in our last class, we saw about credit memos, debit memos, and how to correct the invoices. Okay. So today we will see how we can combine and split the invoices. Okay. So when we say like we have to combine the invoices or we have to split the invoices, the system checks for certain fields in the header document, header value of the billing document. For example, when you say that so and so is a payer, okay, when there are two or more in deliveries that are due for creating invoice for the same payer, then the system checks for certain things like whether the payer is the same, whether the payment date is the same, whether payment terms are the same. Okay, and if everything is the same, then the system combines the deliveries into single invoice. And similarly, the converse is also true. If the system finds any one of these parameters different, even within the same sales order, then the system splits the invoices, which means like you can create a delivery, but for that delivery, more than one invoices will be created. So, one of the most important term that splits the invoices is the payment terms of the customer. Okay, so I am going to create, I am using this scenario to demonstrate the delivery split as well as the invoice split. Okay. Delivery and invoice split. Okay. I am entering three articles for this customer, T-AT101, T-AT102, T-AT103. Let me put as 10 pieces each. I need the same sole to party. I want the corresponding shift to party for the same. I don't want to make any changes in the partner. But whereas I am going to make some changes in the payment terms as well as the input terms. When there are differences in the input terms, the system will split the delivery. When there are differences in the payment terms, then the system will split the invoice. So now I go to the, by default the system has proposed me the payment terms ZB01. Okay. So let me go to billing conditions. Okay. For the first one, CFR is there and ZB01 is the payment terms. For the second item, I am replacing the input terms. Why? Because I want to split the delivery. The delivery split is based on the invoices, input terms, whereas the payment terms is going to be delivered split based on the payment terms. Okay. For the item number 3, okay, fine. For the item number 30, I am retaining the same input terms, but I am going to replace the payment terms. So now when I save and deliver this order, payable 003. So when I save this order and process further, I will be getting two deliveries, that is the delivery split based on the input terms, and I will be getting three billing invoices for the same. Okay, so we will see that. So now I am going to deliver it. Let us take it so slow. Let us see the transaction. no schedule lines up to delivery, so fine. Can you see? I entered 3 items, but the system had taken only 2 items. Okay, so no problem. Let me save it. I give the same parameters, like same shooting point, same delivery selection date, as well as the same order number. So I will come out of that. So VL01N. So the system has delivered the item number 10 and 30. Let me go for the further delivery. This means item number T-80102 is going to be delivered now. Okay. So let me save it. So delivery number 5058 and 5057. I'll do one thing, I'll go to the outbound monitor VL06O and create for picking 1200. Okay. I'm checking the deliveries which are due for picking. Five zero five seven and 5058. These were we created just now. So I'm selecting those two and creating the background. Adopt pick quantity, let me say 2. So let it confirm automatically. If you are very comfortable with sales cycle, because whole of our SD cycle will be depending on only these 3 transactions. If you see at the user level, there will be only these 3. That is creating sales order, creating deliveries, and doing the billing activities. So that is so you will be getting to see the delivery creation and the TO creation or billing creation only more often. Sometimes people used to think that this is the only part of SD. Actually that is the main or core activity of the SD, and all our customizing and enhancing the activities are revolving around these only. So the more comfortable you are with the sales order processing, that is in the front end, the more faster you will be, and you will be able to check your changes more often. What happened? Short dump is being formatted. What it say? Transfer or create. VN02N. Okay. Okay, transfer order. Okay. it at least. Okay, let's see more item. So for a single sales order, we have got two deliveries, that is 8001, 5057 and 5058. Program terminator. Okay, we have created two TOs. Let me go to the delivery. Okay, so we have done the PG also. So let me go to main sales order EA021863 and I go to the document flow. So the item number 10 and 30 will be having one delivery, item number 20 will be having the another delivery. Okay. So for the same sales order, the system generated two deliveries. Even though the shipping point was the same, that is 1200, the selection date was the same, that is 3/9/2011, and even though the sales order was the same, that is 11863, the system split it into two deliveries because of change in the input terms. Okay. So different the input terms are, the system split the delivery. Okay. Now in the same delivery, okay, in this same item, for the item number 10 and 20, we have maintained the same payment term. And for the item number 30, we maintained a different payment term. So the system is going to generate or split the second delivery. So let me show here. Billing document. Okay. So item number 10 and 30 were in the same sales, same delivery. Okay. So item number 30, it is 003 is the payment term, whereas for item number 10 it is going to be it is DB01. So if I create the billing document slash in DS01, okay, slash for ELPOD. Slash N ES01. The system creates two invoices. Can you see? If I go select this document and I go to split analysis asking why did you split, the system says split due to different header data, that is the payment keys were different, that is why the system has split the delivery. transaction VF 01. Okay. So this is how the delivery split. To be put it simple, in all the sales documents, whether it is the delivery or the billing, whenever there is a change in the header data, that is, in delivery the header data can be your shipping point or your info terms or even your date of delivery creation, then the system will split the delivery. And in case of billing, it could be the payer. For example, the sold to party can be the same, but the payer was different in two sales orders. In such cases, the invoice will be split. In case of payment terms being different, the invoice will be split. Okay. In case of that payment date selection date, for example, like for one item you would have given 15 days credit, for another item you would have given 30 days credit. Okay, 30 days lead time for paying the invoices. So in such cases, the system will split the invoices. So as a thumb rule, whenever there is a change in the header data, the document will automatically be split or combined. Okay, this is how the invoice split or invoice combination takes place. Is it clear? Okay. So now, till now we have been seeing all the forward processes, okay, which means a goods started from our place to reach the customer. Okay. So now we are going to see the returns process, which means like there is some discrepancy. So like the returns process is also very much similar to our normal sales process, but only thing is like wherever we do goods receipts, wherever we do outbound delivery, we create inbound delivery. Wherever we did goods issue, we do the goods receipt. Okay. So, VA01. The document type is RE. Okay. So, when I can create returns document either with reference to a sales order or an invoice or even without any reference. So, just now we have created a invoice, so we'll see that. Slash OVF02 33 slash OVF02. Go to the document flow. You could see there were two deliveries and three invoices, 1, 2, and 3. Okay. So let me choose a let me create a sales return with reference to the sales order. Okay, 11863. So create with reference. I give the number 11863. Out of this, so let me say I don't want to return this. So let me delete that line. Before that, you have to send it. Enter the order reason why you are creating that particular returns delivery. Three pieces and two pieces. I am returning. Okay. Slash OVOV8. This return process is also very similar to your standard order creation. Okay, standard sales order creation. Okay. So how it is being differentiated? It is because of our document type. We had seen that by customizing the document type, we can map any kind of business process. So RE, okay, that is return. I am saying if I have given a reference mandatory here, then I must be able, then I must create, then I have to create a return only with reference to either a sales order or billing document. Okay, so as of now I have left it blank. And second thing is, like, it doesn't have the standard delivery LR. Instead it is having a delivery LR. Okay. And similarly the billing types are also different. And it automatically has a billing block because the returns process can be misused. Okay. So there must be some sort of supervision and authorization so that it can be monitored and then released, okay, what can be done. Okay, so that is why we have set an automatic billing block. Okay. So let me go to this. Return order. So it is coming back to the plan 1200 only. Okay. And there is no different delivery date because you are receiving the goods today. Okay. So the system assumes that the customer is ready to give the goods now, or sometimes even the goods have reached your place. So that is why the return delivery date is the same as the date of creation. So let me save it. There is a different number range. The it is not what we got 11863 last time. Okay. So this time it has got a 6 series. So whenever somebody sees, like, okay, it starts with 6, they can easily identify that this is a return sales order. It is a return delivery, and if I go to picking, I could see that picking tabs are grayed out, which means you are not going to pick this delivery. Instead, it is already coming in. So no need of picking from your side. So there is no goods received or there is no relevance for picking. Only thing is how much of goods you are going to deliver. Carry out the, since we had entered, I mean, like last time we entered the different info terms, so the system has reduced this delivery also. We had entered item number 10 and 20. So here only one had come. So we had to create the another return delivery for this. Slash NVA02. We have created one delivery, that is for 3P. Create delivery, another delivery. I do a post goods receipt. If I do the billing part, VM01, the system takes one day the order. Why? Because sometimes you can create the return sales order, okay, but the goods need not actually come inside. The reasons could be many. For example, the goods would have been damaged to the watch, so that no point in taking back. Sometimes, like, your logistics cost will be more, so you might think, like, okay, instead of bringing the article back, okay, let it be with the customer himself. I will create a delivery and post a statistical goods receipt, which means according to the system the goods must have come in, but in physical the goods wouldn't have come. So that is the statistical goods receipt. You would have done a statistical goods receipt So you are not bothered about like how much has come, instead how much you have raised in the same order. So for that only the system is going to create the billing. So this is the order related billing, this is not a delivery related billing. So if I try to post it now, it is going to give me error because it has been blocked for billing. Edit, log. So now I have to go and remove the billing block. Fashion mini A02. Billing block in. Yeah. No, I didn't say anything now. I just said we have to remove the billing block. So now I have saved it. I mean, did you hear the reason why it is a delivery order related billing, not a delivery related billing? Okay, what happens is like sometimes your customer says like the goods have damaged. Goods has been damaged so much, so I want you to take it back. Okay, so in normal scenarios, you will be taking that goods back to your stock. So that is why you are creating a return sales order, return delivery. Okay, so but sometimes the goods would have been damaged so much that it doesn't make sense to take it back to your stock. That is one reason. And another reason is sometimes the cost of the reverse logistics is more. Okay, you feel that it is not economical to bring that goods back to your premises. Okay, so in any of these scenarios, you decide that okay, let the goods be with the customer himself, and instead I post a statistical goods receipt, which means according to the system, the goods had come in. Okay, but in reality or in physical, the goods hadn't come. So this is the statistical goods receipt. You say like okay, let me take the goods statistically or hypothetically. Okay, but I will pay the customer. Okay, so you create a delivery, inbound delivery, and carry out a goods receipt, irrespective of whether the goods actually come in or not. Okay, so that is why the system doesn't bother about the returns delivery. Okay, instead it bills for the quantity which for which you have raised the sales order. Okay, that is why it is a order related billing, not a delivery related billing. Okay, now for the same sales order, the system had created two deliveries. Okay, so I go to split analysis. It says the info terms were different, so that is why the system has split the billing process into two. Again, there is a billing split here. Okay. In this version is not new actually. So let us check whether another type exists. No. Okay. Now, in the new version, that is, we are working with the enhancement package 4. If there is enhancement package 5, which is the newest version. Okay. In that, now we have the advanced returns. For example, just now what we did, we created the returns order first, then we created the returns delivery for that, then we created the returns billing. But if you go to the advanced returns, you can do carry out everything in the same screen. It means like in the same screen you will be entering what is the damage reasons, where it has to be taken back or to which stock it has to be posted to, and in case of refund, how much has to be given as refund, and whether it has to be given as cash or credit memo. Everything you can choose in the single screen. Okay, but not many people are using that functionality because that is the newest one. You can find, I mean like I recently found it out when I was taking class for Siemens, because they have the most updated version. So this is RTEL. Okay, anyway, like when you have the chance to work in any new system, you can always check that. Try with the document type REN, okay, you will be able to carry out that advanced system functionality. Okay. Is it clear? No, I feel like some past few days. Hey, like, had you heard about the, do anybody of you know about the Toyota manufacturing process? What is special about it? Lean, yeah, lean. Which means like the inventory is almost low, almost zero. Okay. For example, if they are manufacturing in a car today morning, okay, so they will be giving the schedule to the vendor. So today morning 10 o'clock I will be assembling the chassis, and 12 o'clock I will be assembling the upholsteries. Okay. So the schedule will be given to the vendors, and the vendors will be sending the their materials to the Toyota factory almost at the exact time. Okay. So it is called as just in time, or and the inventory is called as vendor managed inventory, which means the inventory will be within the plant premises, but those are not the inventories of Toyota. Okay, they are basically the inventories of the vendor. The advantages of the Toyota is there is a zero cost on the inventory, which means the capital is not tied for the inventory. Okay, and second thing is that it is always ensured that you get the raw materials in correct time. Okay, so that is the Toyota model. Okay. That thing we have mapped in SAP as consignment. Okay, when we say consignment, okay, when you say consignment in a normal language, it means like it is the goods that has been shipped from one place to another place. We will be saying it. Consignment is moving on, so we are expecting the consignment to come. Okay, but in SD, when we say consignment, we are talking about this just-in-time process or vendor-managed inventory. So let me say, like, I am a seller, and let me say, Abid is my customer. Okay, so what I do, I am moving some of my stock, regular stock, to consignment stock at the Abid's place. Okay, so even though the stock is at Abid's place, it is not his stock. Instead, it is my stock. So Abid doesn't need to pay anything for that, because the ownership is still with me. And Abid is saying like, okay, Mahesh, today my production is going on. Issue me 10 pieces. Okay, I issue him 10 pieces, and I can bill him only for that 10 pieces. Okay, after some time, Abid says like, okay, I had taken 10 pieces, but I have utilized only 8, so you take back that 2. Okay, so I take that back to my consignment stock. And one time Abid says like, okay, the production is over, now you can clear your stock. So all the stocks that are left with Abid's place, so I take back to the my regular stock. So this is the consignment process in SAP. So consignment process is, it need not be the same as our Toyota just-in-time processing. Sometimes it happens like you are launching a new product. So you are participating with your customer in a trade fair, which means you are not very sure about, you or your customer is not very sure about how much it's going to sell. So you are not selling anything to your customer. Instead, you are participating in the trade fair along with your customer. So in such cases also the consignment process is being used on. Okay. So there are 4 steps. One is consignment issue, consignment status is consignment filler, consignment issue, and we have the consignment return, and finally we are clearing it back. Okay. So this is the data process or just in time process. Okay, which we are going to see. So as I had said previously, like we are going to map this activity by based on the document type customizing. So let me go to VO V8. My CF is the consignment fill up. So this is the, these four are our major documents for this consignment process. Consignment fill up, consignment issue, okay, and finally is the consignment pick up. Sorry, consignment fill up, consignment issue, consignment pick up, and finally is the consignment withdrawn. So let us see the process today, and the same one, it is going to be your same same sort of processing. So I am saying for the customer, I am carrying out the consignment fill up. Okay, so this may be shift to party. T-8101-100-T7. So before that, let us see what is the stock of the article in plan 1200 slash N MMBE. Okay. 101 in 1200. So it is 9,263 pieces. Fine. Okay. You can see there is a change in the item category. It is not our regular CIN. Okay. So I can give you the homework of looking into the item categories of KBN, compare with PIN, and find out what is the difference. Okay, we will be discussing that later. If you find out and tell it earlier, that should be fine. Okay. So I am creating a delivery for this. So this is moving from your place to your customer place, which means you have to carry out it like a typical delivery. So you need a transfer order, you need a transfer order confirmation. So I okay. If I try to build this, I just want to see how the system responds when I try to. It says it's not possible because what you did, you have moved the stock from your place to your customer place, that's it. But the ownership lies with you, so you cannot bill your customers for this delivery. So that is why it says the document is not relevant for billing. Okay. So now I go and check my stock. Okay. I refresh it. I could see it is in the consignment stock. This 100 has moved to consignment stock. So now I am going to issue some of that to my customer. Okay. So I am going to consignment issue. Okay. So this customer, yeah. It basically transfers to the customer place, but it is our goods. The ownership is still with us. Consignment issue, T-8101, let me say 25 pieces. Okay, first it was KBN, now it is KEN. Okay. So, let me deliver it. When I say deliver, can I see it is not relevant for picking? no transfer on the record because the goods are already lying in the customer's place. So there is no need of picking it. Okay. So no transfer order. You can directly do a post goods issue. For this, I can bill my customer. C/BF01 10060. Yeah, I can bill to my customer. Okay. I go to my stock overview and check what is there. Okay. So I had issued 25 to my customer. So the consignment stock is showing as 75. Okay. And okay, everything had gone well. Now I am, my customer says, okay, we are done with, so you can take it back. So I am picking up everything. I created the delivery. You are creating a delivery document basically. No. So that is why there was no picking. Okay. So now the customer says, okay, like we are done with. So shall we pack it up? So you are carrying out something called a consignment pickup. Yeah. Hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Correct. Yeah, that's why we created the delivery first. I mean, you remember, we created a delivery, but we were not able to build that. That was our first delivery. Yeah, first time we did the picking. First time we did the picking because picking is normally carried out from our premises. Okay, so for the first delivery, if you see this recording again, you can see first time we created a delivery, for that we created the picking and we did the PGI. Okay, but we are not able to build that because the goods are moving from our stock to our customer stock. That's it. Okay, for the second time we created a delivery because even though the goods is physically in the customer's place, for our records, how much we are giving to that customer, we created a delivery. Since the goods are already in the customer's place, there is no need of picking. Okay, so there was no picking. Instead, we did the PGI directly in the delivery itself. Okay. Yeah. For each step, we'll be creating each delivery. Now I'm taking it back. Okay, so for this also I am going to create another delivery. But the issue, the delivery, that is, the only transaction will be billed when you do the consignment issue. Which means you are giving a part of goods to your customer. One thing, just hold on.
Yes, sir. I am finishing this stuff and
okay, so only time when you give the goods to your customer, that particular delivery is only relevant for billing. Okay. Now, the customer says, okay, we are done with, so we don't need these goods anymore. So, we are now taking or picking up our goods. So, that is the consignment pickup. Okay. So, for this, I have to create a returns delivery. Okay. So, the goods are coming from my customer's place to our stock. So there is no return for picking. It is almost like a return delivery. Okay. So there is no need for picking or transfer order. So I do a post goods receipt directly in the delivery itself. Now if I go to the stock, see, can you see all the goods has moved to our regular stock. So this is the standard move. And it may look confusing initially because you carry out three steps. Okay, but we'll see all those steps in detail tomorrow. Okay, so why? What is the customizing and item categories? How it controls it? No. That is down the sense like that account has been suspended. So I will upload in somebody's place today. I will do that. Because that account has been closed since. Because yesterday I tried to upload some documents into that. At the time it was not. So today I will make other arrangements. Sure. I'll do that. I will add it now. Okay. We'll catch up. Yeah, thank you. Bye. Yeah.